U.S. coronavirus death toll right now, tonight, is on the verge of topping 133,000 people dead. And Dr. Anthony Fauci tonight telling it like it is.
As a country, when you compare us to other countries, I don't think you can say we're doing great. I mean, we're just not.
We're just not. It is a far cry from what we are hearing from the President of the United States.
We've done a great job, whether it's ventilators or anything you want to look at, testing. We test so many people that we have more cases.
All right, more on his testing point in just a moment, because it's factually inaccurate, the point he's making. The truth is, no matter how great Trump says the United States is doing, the numbers don't lie. So take a look at this. We're going to show you the numbers. In just 4 weeks in the United States of America, we have gone from 2 million to 3 million coronavirus cases. We are now at our highest 7-day average of cases since the beginning of the pandemic. And the crucial way to look at this is also the rate of positive infections. That has also gone up. So for every group of people you test, what percent of them are positive? That's an indication of how widely and quickly the virus is spreading. According to that 7-day average, we are now at 8.2% positivity. It is doubled, up from 4.4% just 1 month ago. WHO says you need to be south of 5. We have doubled to more than 8. And as the number of cases rise, so too is the amount of time people are waiting to get tested. So people still can't get the tests. Remember these images back in March, people waiting hours to get tested across this country? We are again now seeing long lines outside testing places. In some places, people are waiting 4 to 5 hours. And on the front lines, once again, the same crisis that we saw when this hit the Northeast. Now a shortage of masks, gowns, face shields, and gloves. And in Houston, doctors at one hospital reportedly being told to reuse single-use N95 masks for up to 15 days as they treat coronavirus patients. And the nation's largest organization of registered nurses found in late June that 85% of its members had been forced to reuse disposable N95 masks while treating coronavirus patients. I sound frustrated because I am. I mean, this is deja vu. We've been there before. This wasn't supposed to happen again. And these images mirror what we saw months ago at the height of the pandemic in New York City. Patients being treated in tents because hospitals were overflowing. And when it comes to hospitalizations, by the way, the White House is trying to say, don't worry about those numbers going up. There's no there there. Here's the argument.
Hospitalizations in the country are up 50% since mid-June. How can the president say that the country is in good shape right now?
So I would note with hospitalizations in a lot of these hospitals, I spoke with Dr. Birx this morning, about 10 to 40% in the hospitals reaching high capacity are COVID. So a lot of hospitalizations aren't pertaining to COVID. What I would also note, and I'm glad—
Hospitalizations is not because of COVID?
Well, a lot of it is elective surgeries and other surgeries that have opened up.
So elective surgeries, that is the line from the White House. It is not true. So let's just take the numbers again. We'll show you Texas, which hit a record in deaths in a single day today. Look at the spike in COVID hospitalizations. COVID, coronavirus, not elective surgery. Less than 2,000 in early April, nearly 10,000 now. That is not elective surgery. Hospitals are strained in many places, and states are being told they may need to shut down again. And yet the president says he disagrees with Dr. Fauci when Dr. Fauci says the United States is knee-deep in the crisis. You know, I actually talked to the doctor who helped eradicate smallpox, and he told me that Fauci, who we all know is very conservative, didn't even go far enough on this one.
We're not knee-deep. We're hip-deep, and if we don't do something dramatically, we'll soon be neck-deep.
The president just denies that. He wants you to think, and you heard him at the beginning, right? I said I was going to get back to this, that the whole reason that we're seeing this increase in cases is because we are testing more people. He keeps saying that. So for those of you who are tempted to believe him, let me explain why this is wrong. So first of all, he said today, for the 100th time, the reason we show so many cases compared to other countries that haven't done nearly as well as we have is that our testing is much bigger and better. Well, for the 100th time, this is false. It is not because of testing. Here are the numbers. Nationwide testing in the United States of America up by 7% over the past week. Cases over that time up by 24%. So that's nationwide, okay? He's wrong. How about states with the highest cases? Well, let me show you Arizona. Back on June 7th, Arizona tested 14,100 people. The number of positive tests were just over 1,500. Today, they tested 12,000 people. The number of positive tests, 3,500. In English. Fewer tests, more cases. Caitlin Collins is out front live at the White House tonight. Caitlin, Dr. Fauci, again, painting a very different picture of the situation than the president, and the president's, what he says simply does not align with the facts.
Yeah, and the president not only is trying to portray this optimistic portrait of what is going on, he wants to tell you things that aren't actually happening, like how he is with the testing numbers and saying that if we tested half the people, we'd have half the cases, but also on so many other things. And that's why you've seen the president often be at odds with Dr. Fauci, who not only is not only focusing on just the optimistic stuff, he's giving people this realistic view of actually what's going on in the country. And so the question is, you know, how is the president breaking with one medical expert, but it's also several others as well, Erin, including the CDC director, Robert Redfield, who we are still having all of this confusion about what their guidance is going to be on reopening schools. And we are just weeks away from some teachers actually going back to schools. You saw Dr. Redfield this morning in an interview saying they're actually not going to be changing that CDC guidance after there was confusion yesterday about whether or not they were. He now says they're only going to issue additional information. And so the question of how that squares with the president complaining about the CDC guidance as it was explained by the White House today by saying, well, they don't have to subscribe to everything that's in the guidance, these schools, because it's just that, guidance. But Erin, the problem with that is, and the president saying, well, you have to all reopen, is they are basically telling these schools, it's up to you to decide how to reopen and how to socially distance your children and your students, but we're going to tell you when to reopen, and they say that that has to be now, and they want everyone back in the classrooms, not just, you know, a staggered schedule or some of these limited classrooms like we've seen suggested.
All right, Caitlin, thank you very much. I want to go now to Dr. Sanjay Gupta, our chief medical correspondent, and Dr. Ashish Jha, the director of the Harvard Global Health Institute. So, Sanjay, for the 100th time, the president says that the increase in cases is due to the United States doing better than any other country on testing. So for the 100th time, the facts, of course, do not show that, right? Cases are going up more quickly than tests. And in fact, in some of the hotspots, testing has gone down as cases have gone up.
And hospitalizations have gone up as well, right? So even if you say, hey, look, the testing is, you know, if you buy into that narrative, which is absolutely not true for all the reasons you mentioned, you're also seeing an increase in hospitalizations. If you look at the trend map here, I think this is instructive. See sort of what's happened since the beginning of this pandemic here in the United States. You'll see that the numbers sort of, they came to their lowest point, I think, right around June 1st. And at that point, we had some 17,000 people who became infected on that day annually. And then really since then, for the last, what, 6 weeks now, 5.5 weeks, the numbers have been going up, and they've obviously surpassed the highest point from before. So, you know, things are clearly going in the wrong direction. And at this idea that, hey, it's because we're testing more, not acknowledging the problem as a result, I'm worried we're not going to be able to fix it. How do we fix a problem that we're not even acknowledging?
Right. Well, and the president acknowledges it, Dr. Jha, right? So first they're trying to say there's no hospital issue because people are going back for elective surgeries. Which just completely ignores the point that COVID hospitalizations have been surging for COVID, not for elective surgeries. And yet, you know, from time and time again, we hear the president giving a different reality. Here's just a few examples.
We understand the disease. We've learned the virus is abating and the crisis is being handled. We're putting out the fires. We did it right. We saved millions of lives by what we did.
So what do you say, Dr. Jha, when the president of the United States says the numbers are only going up today because of testing?
Yeah, so, you know, it's sort of like we're in the middle of a hurricane and our political leaders are saying it's sunny and warm outside and it's not raining. It's sort of hard to know where to begin, but so let's just do a few fact checks. We have not done more testing than anybody else in the world. China's done much more testing than us. On a per capita basis, lots of countries have done more tests. Russia has done more tests per capita than we have. This is just silliness. This is not about testing. Every doctor, every public health person understands that what we have is large outbreaks of this disease happening in large parts of our country. Hospitalizations are going up, and in those states, deaths are going up. People are dying of this disease. There are more people dying of this disease now than there were 2 weeks ago and 4 weeks ago in the hotspot states. This is incontrovertible. The debate and discussion we need to be having is, what do we do about it? How do we protect lives? How do we open up our economy? And not the stuff about, are we doing more testing than anybody else? We're just not.